Jira. So what is Jira and how it is going to work out? So all the tasks. So let's see what is a Jira and how it is helpful. So Jira is a project management tool. It is created by Australian company Atlassian, and this Jira software is built for every member of your software team to plan, track, and release the software. Right, that's the Jira tool. What it can do? It is used for bug tracking, issue tracking, project management. All these tasks you can perform in this Jira tool. And your entire project management can be handled in this Jira tool inside. And the Jira dashboard consists of many useful functions, features. So you can just set up all this, the kind of dashboard you will get like this. So the Jira software, and you will get a Jira dashboard, and you can plan, you can track whatever your stories and issues, plan sprints, and distribute tasks across your software team members. All this you can plan it. Then you can prioritize the task, and you can track the task, how you are performing, your team is performing, can be tracked very easily with this Jira tool. So I'll show you in a short time everything, and Jira workflow. When you first, it will be in a to-do list, then open in progress, under review, then final approval, then done. So this is a complete thing, and so we'll see what are all these things, how you can handle this Jira, how you can just, if you go to any website, just open google.com, okay. So just type Jira software. Maybe you can also request your own account with this Jira, right? You can do that. So on this one, and now just type Jira software. Okay. So Jira software, it is coming from Atlassian company here. Atlassian. Start your free trial. As you can say, start your free trial. You can get it's open source, it's not open source, it's a commercial tool. Maybe you can use 15 days or something like that. So Jira software is going to provide so many options. You can use the Confluence, you can use a Jira software management, so many options are there. And you can use all this project and issue tracking purpose, you can use. And you don't need any credit card for this, but you can continue. Just software, if you want, you can provide it, and then click on next. And then it's a free trial, so you can see free trial. Then you'll get a get started. You can log in with this Jira software cloud free. It is because it is deployed. Jira software is deployed on the cloud, so that you can access directly. Everything ready made they will give, and they will set up everything for you and give it to you. You don't need to do all the things again and from the scratch. So you can just log in with this your Google account. You can create account free for up to 10 users. You can create an account, and then you can set up. So let's see how you can do that. And I have created this thing. Maybe you can just see that this is the Jira software. You can click on this and you will go to a dashboard. This is a dashboard page. So the projects it will show and switch to. You can see this is the Jira software. This is the Jira software. You have so many options again. Confluence you have. So many options you have. So you can create your own project also. You can create your own project also. Just you can see here, create project. You can just go here and the menu bar. You can see create a project, and all the projects you can see by clicking on this project tab. Or you can just go to dashboards and you can see all the dashboard. You can create a dashboard also. People you can add, that I'll show you how to add people. This is the project I just created. How to create a project? So to create a project, you just log into this Jira board and then click on projects, create new project, or three all projects under also you have a create project option. Either this one also can use, right? So this is the one, and you can go back to Jira software, and you can see once you click on this project, click on this project. Once you click on the project, you can see in the left panel so many options you have. So the project, so this one, the project name and classic software project. So this the with the project name, this is create a board. Board also created, active sprint, and I don't have anything in my this project. So nothing is available right now. Nothing is a backlog. If you select, there is nothing in this backlog. Backlog is nothing but a product backlog. So which has all the requirements. That's a product backlog. What is a product backlog? All the requirements will be there. That's a product backlog. So you can create a product backlog, and you can create a new story also, or you can create a here so new option will be there, and you can create, or you click on this create option, create a new story also. But we'll see first. So open our requirements document. Okay, this is our requirements document, right? This is the functional objectives and the purpose of this document, and we'll create one use case model, right? This is the main, this is a requirement specification document for a new web-based sales system for solar-based energy. So this is a new sales system for solar-based energy. SBE is a distributor of alternative energy products, including windmills, photovoltaics, and fuel cells. Too many things you can sell, right? That's the web application for this. Okay. Solar web-based application for your sales purpose. So if anybody wants to sell and they have to register with this website, that's our main goal you need to understand. So this is the complete use cases, and the use cases are given here. The project is, the project name is SBE sales system. We'll create a project, okay? With this name, I'll create a project. Okay? With this name, I'll create a project. SBE sales system. Let's create a project. And our project managers and everybody is given here. Project analyst, everybody is available here. Responsible users are many people will be involved. That we'll discuss. Project scope, system purpose, so like who can use, and these are the people, customers, sales agents, product owners, customer service department, marketing department, accounting department, purchase information. So a lot of information is provided here. Okay. The primary responsibility of system also provided here. So we'll create a project, and I'll show you how to create a new project, and then we'll define the all the things. So high priority, see that high priority, medium priority, so then low priority. What is a non-functional objective? Reliability, usability, performance, security, supportability, online user documentation and help, purchase components. So these are all very clearly defined in the requirement document, right? So this is a design diagram, SBE sales system. That's a solar-based energy sales system. That's a thing. That's our project name. We can create that project. So this is the system use case. So all the things. Let's see how to create a project first. Okay, how to create a project. So we'll create a project first. Okay, then I'll show you how to create a project first. Create a project. So install and configuration, you understand, right? How to do. So just go here and continue with Google. And it will be installed automatically, configured for you. So it will configure and give you username, password. Then you can see, continue with the Google if you do. Let me show you the installation also. I'm going to show you Jira software with cloud one, cloud application. How to do that? Bit slow. And it will create a one account. Okay, you can create an account. So for this. It's okay, use another account. I'm just using that. You can give a thing, and but it is asking a Google account. Okay, this is asking a Google account. But fine, let me use one account which I'll use. So where I'll leave my the installation of Jira I'm showing. Create my account. You can just click on create my account. So you're first creating an account with Atlassian Jira, where you have to give that is okay. So it will come to the next page. How to install, I'm showing how to install Jira. You can practice this also. See that checking few things. It will ask you a few important things, preparing your site. And you can also install your Jira software in your system. You can play around with it. And if you want to do, you can just go to the website and select a try for free. Try it free, and it will select a cloud one, cloud software, and it is starting automatically. You can just give here your site name. So with that, one link will be created to you. That link you can access. So for us, here you can see I have created a Ramesh QA online Atlassian.net. This is the URL they will give it to us. Once you give this name, whatever the name you are giving, this name is a matter. With that one website URL, it will be given to you. With that, you can log in and you can continue. That's what this, you have to continue that by giving this. Once I give that, I got this. So after that, so you will get all this logged in here. And you go to dashboards. So you can go to dashboard. So view all dashboards. You can go here. And if you go to dashboard, nothing is there. Just you can create a dashboard also. So you will have a default dashboard. You can see just a default dashboard is there. See that you can have a welcome to Jira and assign nothing to me. Active stream projects. No projects here. I think one project is there, right? That will come here. Your company is Jira, it will come like. So this is a default dashboard you will get here. So this is the, you can create your own dashboard also. This is the first tab, dashboard tab. So, and then you can, if you want to create a project, right? So you have to click on this projects tab. Then click on create project. I'm showing how to create a project. What we need to do? First, you have to log into the Jira, then projects tab, then create a new project, and you can choose classic project or next generation project. You can choose whichever options you want. So you have here this classic project, you have a roadmaps, advanced roadmaps, card layout or customization, reports, estimations, so many you have, right? So that you can see, select a classic, right? Select a classic and give the project name. Project name, we decided to give this name, right? Let's give this project name. What is our project name? We decided to give SBE sales system, right? SBE, I think SBE enough, right? Or we can give proper name. So I don't want to make any mistake. Let's give SBE. Project name SBA sales system. Okay, that's the same SBA sales system.
We don't have that project, right, sir, with us?
Yeah, so you can create your own, okay? You can create your own, anything, just roughly. Then you can change the, here you can change Scrum, this template. You want Scrum template or you want a different template? Let me click on change if you want a different one other than Scrum. You have Kanban, monitor work in a continuous flow for agile teams, suits, teams who control work volume from backlog. So this is the one, or Scrum or bug tracking. So these are the options you have. So select a Scrum, okay? And Scrum will be selected and manages stories, tasks, and workflows for a Scrum team, for teams that deliver work on a regular schedule. So the Scrum team you select, then click on create. This is our project, how to create. How to create a project, once you log in and this click on project, and then create project, then give the project name and select the this project name. See that it is created. This is the project, classic software project. It is coming very clearly, SBA sales system. So with this, this it is created SS board. SS board it is created. And so you can just now, we need to click on backlogs. So What is a backlog? A backlog is a requirements. What is a backlog? A product backlog, we call this. A product backlog is, so it is a all the requirements. So all the new requirements are epic or user stories are available here. That's a product backlog. Okay. New requirements are epic or user stories are available here. And then, so we can just go to backlog, click on backlog, okay, from your project, you click on backlog, you can see backlog is zero issues. We don't have any issues here. We don't have any backlog, new requirements, we don't have anything. And then, so can you see here versions, epic, we don't have any epic calls. What is epic? Epic is a huge requirement. What is epic? So epic is a huge requirement. So an epic is a huge requirement. So an epic can contain, right? An epic can contain, so this is the one, epic. So epic can contain again different stories again. So the story one, let me another story.
What is that, sir? Epic is a huge requirement, you said? What?
Huge requirement, very big one. Very big requirement. That's a epic. Epic is a big requirement. So maybe a big feature. That's an epic. So epic is subdivided into this. So these things. This is one user story. And then this is another user story. Story. So it will be again divided into, it will be again divided into another stories. So here, stories. One epic may contain more stories. One epic may contain more stories. So one epic may contain a story. So one epic may contain many stories also. A story is nothing but a small feature. Small feature. A story is nothing but a small feature. So epic may contain more user stories. So one more user story. So that's a one epic can contain multiple user stories. So that's the epic means. Okay, so we'll write just here another story, user story. So story two, this is the story one. You can say story one, story one, this is the story two, story three. So one epic may contain more than one features, more than one new features, new scenarios, new user stories. So that is called epic. A story means small requirement, like login scenario, registration, and payment gateway. So this is the story means. Epic means very big one. So that epic will create here. So let's create an epic for this. So we first click on this version. What is the version? We don't have any version here, right? See that? No version here. I'll just create with this. Version for this project, SSSV 1.0. I'll just create like this, and you can give a start date, and we'll give later this start date and release date, all these things. Okay, just version you create. So now see, version is created for this project, and then we don't have any epic. So let's create epic. So what is epic? Epic is a all, so you can create an epic is done. So we need to create an epic now. So what is an epic? Epic is a big requirement, big functionality. That's epic. Okay, just click on epic. So you can see here issue type. So what are the different issue types you have in Jira? So issue types, we have epic, task, story, bug. These are the issue types. Everything is an issue here in the Jira. A test case is an issue. A epic is an issue. A task is an issue. Subtask is an issue. A story is an issue. A bug is or a defect is an issue. That's the issue types. So what are all the issue types? Issue types can be epic, task, story, bug, or a test. All these are issue types or subtask. So these are all considered as a issued you. See the project, for this project, I'm creating an epic. For this project, I'm creating an epic. So epic means you can just give SSS epic 01, and you can just give solar based energy sales features. So that's I just created. So I'll give this summary epic name. The summary means I'll just give the summaries. Maybe by seeing the this thing, you can just do that. The important SB cells, state of the alternatives, solar power. Just I'll give it like simple, okay? So I don't want much. Okay, that's the one. And create one. So create. So epic is created now. See that epic is created now. So we created an epic. We created a right. So version we created an epic also. But we didn't create any issues for this epic. So let's create an issue. So we create an issue. You can click on this create issue. So then a create issue means issue, I told you, issue can be a story, an epic, a task, or a bug, or a test case, or subtask. Anything is an issue. So now I want to create now a story. So I want to create a story for this epic. I want to create a story for this epic. So let's create a story for this epic. So new story, and what you can create here, I can click on this. Click on create button. You can create, or you can click on this. You can create an issue also. Here also you can create. So here also you can create an issue. So you can create an issue here for this project. And you can create an issue here. Otherwise, you just go back to project. So let me backlog, go to backlog. So here I can see I want to create a new issue. So new story in backlog. So I think you can click on this create button. Yeah, you can click on this create button. Now this time I need to create a story. I need to create a story. So for a story, for which project? The project name, the issue type is a story, and I'm going to create. So this first feature, first login feature, that's a first, my first one I'll create. First one is registration, right? First one is not login. First you should have a registration. So register user is my first story. So I can just give a SSS U001 register user. That's my first. And you can enter your description components, if any components are there. No, nothing components. If you want any documents, you can attach the documents, and you can write all the description about this. So what is the description? So you can add all this description summary. So we can give a summary of this, right? So then you can write all the requirements. So all the basic flow you can add. So what are the basic flow? You can just write a basic. So you can write a basic flow. So this is the basic flow. This is the basic flow. And this is the summary, right? Summary. So this summary, you can just select this. And basic flow is, so write all the basic flow steps. So these are all the basic flow steps. So then, alternative flows. So this all, who will do this, all this task? It's all done by product owner. It's all done by product owner or business analyst. Remember this, okay? This is not done by us. The tester is not going to do all these things. So I'm just showing you how this things are done in the Jira. Other than that, you don't need to do all this. This is not done by testers. So that's one. Next, we have a any preconditions? No, no preconditions. You can just put a business rules also. You can put a business rules also like this. So business rules, and so that's how we can post conditions and preconditions. So just do this. Okay, so like this. Then you can create link issues. We don't have any link issues, but maybe you can do any epic keys there. You can do epic name, issue, fix version, assignee, automatic. You can put assign to me, priority, epic link. You can give epic link, so it will come automatically. Epic link, see that is the epic we created. So the epic you can add. So this, for this epic, we are creating a story for creating a new requirement. So sprint will add later. So this is the how it will be created. So you can see now under backlog, now it is showing first user story. Then you can create a new issue again. See that here you have a create issue, one more. So click on create issue. So you can add that issue, otherwise you can click on create. Let's add second one. Now login user. Now, so SSS-userstory US002 and login user. That's our second user story. So you can give all this same things. Here, let's create all this. How to create a user stories? I'm just giving first summary, and then so just select all these things, then close it. So we'll do that, all the points one after the other. So summary, you can just give, but right, the basic flow, you can go to next basic flow, you can do that. Then alternative flows, we have alternative flows, and I can say step 4, and then extinction. So we have any extinction, just styling all this. If you want, you can do that whatever the way you want. So see that the preconditions is user must be logged in, and the post conditions user must be seen. This is the how you can create a all the things that you can see whatever you want. You can so format it how you want to format. You can do that formatting. So this is all done by purely product owner or business analyst. You are not going to touch this. You are not responsible for all these things. So this user story also belongs to same epic. Okay. So that's the second backlog issue. Backlog means what? All the user stories. So that user stories comes from client will give all of them. So this product owner will go and talk to them, and he will give the, they will give the requirements, and he will prepare like this. That's, I'm adding all the so product backlogs. So create one more. So let's add all the product backlog. So let's add all the product backlog. Okay, another story I'm creating. What is the next story?
So, user stories are given by client or business analyst, sir?
Client will give for a business analyst. Okay. Business analyst will frame them in the document wise. That's he is adding now. You have a tool, Jira tool. In the Jira tool, directly you will write. Okay.
It's just like requirement document, sir.
Exactly. Exactly. It's just a requirement document. That's it. Right? So, all the requirements will be placed. This is a requirement. That's user story is nothing but a requirement. User story is nothing but a requirement. Okay. I'm just creating a quickly so that we can finish all. Okay. We didn't add the epic. So we need to add the epic. Okay. So if you want to edit, click on this to edit. Add so many points going to come. I will explain you later. So want to add what story points letter. So epic I want to add. I'm just checking. So 6 more fields. Epic. Yeah, it's epic. Just add epic. This epic. We should add it. That's it. Okay. So that's the one thing. Next, create again another thing. What is SSS-004, right? User story 004. I'm just adding, and then place an order by the customer, right? Place an order by customer. So you can write this one, place an order by customer.
So every okay, so epic, that, we need to write the test cases based on these epic stories.
That I'll come. So that we are going to see very detailedly here, how to do. These are all things I'm going to explain, don't worry, okay? So how we are going to, once you understand, so what is the complete hierarchy of your project, okay? So let me add to, I forget again to add. Fourth user story, I forget to add, more fields. Epic, I forget to add. Let's add the epic. Epic only one, only right? Just add the epic. Okay, done. Next, create a one more user story. Like this, all the requirements will be placed in the product backlog. A product backlog means it's a repository where you can keep all your requirements. So that's the very simple thing. Other than that, nothing. So US005, and you can give to next one. As of now, we'll stop here, okay? I will add these five user stories. Maybe we can add later, no issues. Place an order, sales agent, place the order. Okay. So then you can add any attachments, are there any documents, are there? You can add all those things. Okay, that's a thing we can do. And maybe I'll add later, okay? Just epic you select, have priority. Priority also we can change later. Priority, it will be there for the this. So you can give this. And the sprint we'll add because we didn't start the sprint again, right? These are the five product backlogs are there, okay? So now what we did till now, we have created the project, and then for that project, we created a version. Then we created a epic. Then for that epic, and where we are creating all this epic version in the backlog. So you can see in the your project, there is a backlog. So go to backlog, you can click on version, you can create a version. You can click on epic, you can create an epic. So then for this, you can create an issue. So issue can be anything, right? Issue can be a bug, a task, a story, or an epic. It can be anything issue type. Issue types are many things in the Jira. So these are the things under product backlog. What will be there? The user stories will be there. The story will be there. Story or user story, same. Okay. So stories will be there. Now we need to start. Now how to create a sprint for this project? How to create a sprint for this project? So here I have added so few things. How to do all these things? Now we need to add. See this. How to create a project, I have shown you. How to add users, I need to do. And the issue types are, these are the epic, story, task or subtask, bug. So let me add the people to this project. So I want to add the people to this project. How can you add? So just go to your Jira software. Go to Jira software. So you don't need to do any change here. So what you can do, on the top right side, settings, and user management. So here you can add all your users. So I already added Swarupa, you added, and I need to add Shanti, right? I need to add Shanti. So let me add Shanti. I'll add you also to this project. So invite team member. Something went wrong when adding users to your site.
You already added me, sir. I think Swarupa.
Yes, for this you don't have right. For this project, I didn't add you. Only one.
This is new project sample.
Yeah, now I sent you. You have been invited to join your site. Okay, now I sent you invitation. Then it will show you all your users. See that? Two users I have. Right? You two people I added now. So I added the people. How to add the people to any project? So every project is different, and you don't have access to all projects in the Jira. So your project manager or your scrum master will add you to that project. Now for example, you allocated to some project, X project. And that X project manager or scrum master will add your Jira permissions to you. Only that project related, he will add to that project. Then you can access only that project. Otherwise, you cannot access other projects. So that's a kind of, you know, permissions will be given to every person. Then how can you go back? You can go back to this, click on this, or you click on this, and you can click on Jira software, it will go back to home page. So this is the project space you reach, and you will get it back here. Now, and all this, now click on your project. Which is your project? This is your project. So this is your project, and you came to, you have a project name. See, with the project name itself, the dashboard is going to create. And then you have a roadmap, you have a backlog, active sprints, but still we haven't started the sprint, right? And we are in the backlog. Now we are in the back. So now I need to create a sprint. Create a sprint. What is a sprint? A sprint is a certain duration. A 2 weeks period is called a sprint. A specific period of time is called a sprint. So a sprint is a duration of your functionality to be delivered. That's a sprint. A sprint is a particular duration. You will create that sprint. On that sprint, we are all the team members going to work on that. That's a sprint. And this sprint, so let's see, got it. Okay. So now I'll click on this create sprint option. Where you can get this? You log in, then you create a project. In the project, you have a backlog. In the backlog, you have a create sprint option here. So now a sprint is not started. So I'm creating a sprint. Create a sprint. Click on create a sprint. Then sprint is started. So now create a sprint. And so then in the sprint, nothing is there. Plan your sprint. As a team, agree on what work needs to be completed and drag these issues to the sprint. Now plan a sprint. So once you created a sprint, now see that with this SSS sprint one, the sprint is created. Zero issues, no issues now. Can you see here? Nothing is there in this sprint. Nothing is there in this sprint. But how can you add the stories to the sprint? How can you plan the sprint? So first, let's plan the sprint. We created a sprint. That is this name. If you want, you can modify by clicking the three dots here. Just click on this. Edit sprint. You can edit the sprint. So you can give a different name. But let's keep this sprint. So what are the sprint goals? Complete the given stories in sprint one. So that's how it will happen. So this is the complete the given stories in sprint one. So that's a story or description I have given here. Now, so plan the sprint, plan a sprint, and meeting notes, product requirements. So go free form with a custom page and tailor it to your team's needs. So I'll just go this. So I don't want any this one. Let's see what go to product backlog. So it is going to show current sprint. Sprint. Now, so the sprint will start the sprint. There is an option, start sprint option will be there. So I can close this. I don't want this. I can close this. Let me close this. So we have all the So how can I start my sprint? I can start my sprint. How can I start? So what you can do, first these stories, which stories you want to pull from backlog to current sprint. So where this will be decided? The sprint plan meeting. Sprint plan meeting will happen. In the sprint plan meeting, before starting the sprint, they will decide, okay, in this sprint, what are all the user stories need to be developed, tested, and released. So that will be taken care. Now, in this sprint, I'm taking up these two sprints. User story one and user story two, I'm planning to sprint one. Now, I will add these issues to this sprint one. How to add user stories to sprint? Just a drag and drop, okay? Just drag and drop. See that it is added. See that immediately start sprint is started. Next. this one, just a drag and drop here. That's it. So in the current sprint, two user stories are going to work in 15 days of time. In how many issues are there? Two issues are there. Then start sprint, you click on. So what we did, we created a sprint. In the sprint, we added the user stories. That means new functionality you are adding because you are going to work on them. Then click on start sprint. Click on start sprint. So now the sprint will start. So that 2 weeks is period. So remember, any sprint period is 2 weeks or 3 weeks maximum. Maximum 1 month. But ideal sprint time is 2 weeks. They will ask you, what is the sprint duration? How many sprints it will go? So total number of user stories, and based on the complexity, they will plan this number of sprints. And then, so each sprint will be 2 weeks. See, today the sprint is started. Start date is 19th. And automatically it will calculate the end date. Complete the sprint one user story. So 001 user story 002. So these are the user stories. We are going to finish them. And then you can click on start. Start the sprint. There are 10 working days in the sprint. So sprint is started. Sprint is successfully started. Now it has to show all this. Now go to active sprints. And it will show there are no active sprints. Why no active sprints? Just now we started a sprint, right? Dashboard, start sprint in the backlog. Let's go and start it. Why we started, right? Yeah, it is there. Start date. That is done. Plan a sprint closed. The online is closed.
Always sprint is for 2 weeks, sir.
Sorry?
Every sprint is for 2 weeks exactly.
So you have options here. So many Atlassian is developing so many products like Jira, and then you have a Confluence space for documentation purpose. Trello, Bitbucket, these are code management purpose. People are using this Bitbucket, source code management. So this is a Bamboo for release management. So these are so many products this Atlassian has developed. And now let's log in. Yeah, I think it is already there. So this is the one. Product is started.
So will it take much longer today, because I have my physical therapy at 10 o'clock.
Yeah, I'm done. So today, just give me another few minutes. Yes, just waiting. See that? Now you got it. See that? The current active sprints is selected, and the sprint name is coming, and all the issues are showing here. So in the to-do list. To-do list means you haven't started it. Then once you start in progress to go, then a lot of things will be there. See, 9 days remaining. So you can complete the sprint after 10 days, 15 days, basically 15 days, 2 weeks, right? 15 days. So this I'll show you tomorrow, how to work on this, how to create a task for this user stories. So as a tester, what you will do? As a developer, what they will do for each story? You need to create a tasks, subtasks. So what are the tasks? As a tester, what you will do? What is your roles in the testing?
We need to use the use cases and write the test cases.
Okay, then?
Then execute the test cases and report the bugs.
That's it, only that's it?
Can you ask the question again, sir?
So as a tester, what you will do? What is your task?
Oh, okay. Need to understand the requirement document and then design the test cases, write the test cases, execute the test cases. Once the build is ready, we need to do the smoke test first, then a detailed test, the retest, regression test. After that, if they find any bugs, then we need to report the bugs along with the priority and severity to send the report to the developers. And once the developer fixed the bugs, we need to do the regression test and retest it. And we need to update everything with the, all the team members who are related to that testing.
Okay. So all these are all the activities, right?
Yes.
All
sir.
These activities we need to add to this user story.
Okay.
So creating the user story, creating the test case, then reviewing the test case, then execute the test case and reporting that a fix. That also takes time. Reporting that a fix also your task. Then
okay.
Retesting and regression testing is your task. So these are all tasks as a tester you are going to do. All those tasks you need to add for that user story. How to add a task to particular user story? As a testing point of view, those are your tasks. As a developer, what he will do? So those, they will do, they will design, right, for that user story. Then they will code it. Then they will do unit testing. Then they will build it, right? These are the developer tasks. For every user story, these are the developer tasks. And all these tasks will be added to this user story. And we'll assign to that testing team. So first, let's create a task for this, right? Let's create a task, simple task we'll create. So it will open like this. So then you have a create subtask option with this icon will be there. Create subtask. I'm just creating a testing, right? A testing, SSS, create test case. So one task, subtask. Then review test case, review test cases. So these are all subtasks we are creating. After review test case, what will be the next task? What will we execute test or do a smoke, perform smoke testing. Perform
smoke test.
Smoke test. So this is the next test task. Next test, execute the test cases and build. So next, what is the next task?
Bug
defect reporting. Defect reporting. So what is the next task?
Regression.
Yeah,
retesting, bug fix
verification,
right? Retesting and regression testing.
Then regression.
So these are all your testing tasks, right? Then what are the developer tasks for this? So dev, I'll just add a dev, okay? Plus dev. Dev task design. So first they will design, right? Designing should be done. And then so add
coding.
More tasks like this. What are all, who are all going to work on that? They task you need to add. So dev, so coding. So after that, what they will do?
Unit testing.
So they have to do unit testing. So then after that, what they will do?
Integration.
And, component and unit and
so they will do build. So they will build it. After unit testing, they will build it.
That's integration.
So build preparation. Build means nothing but integration only, all this. Build preparation. So build preparation. So these are all the tasks they are going to perform. So now just refresh. See that you can close this. Now you can see all the stories. Just refresh what will happen. You see that. All the tasks, subtasks will be shown here. All the subtasks will be shown here. See that all subtasks for this user story. Oh, it is added for this. Oh, fine. It's okay. For any user story, it has added. All the subtasks are added to this user story. Okay. So 10 subtasks are added for user register 1. And then register 2, we didn't add. We have to add. We'll add later. So like this. So then you can assign to particular tester or developer who is working on this area. This subtask, who is going to work on this subtask. So that I'll show you tomorrow, how to add a user to particular tasks, who is going to work.